Serling. You're listening to The Zero Hour. Rest your eyes. Exercise your imagination. Today, Kim Weisskopf's twisted tale of modern times. A shortage story. Starring Jackie Cooper. In a Mutual Broadcasting System presentation of The Zero Hour.
Brought to you by the makers of Hallmark Cards, Monroe Shock Absorbers, Nabisco, Kodak, and the Ford Motor Company. This is The Zero Hour on Mutual Radio.
Crisis. To be extravagant is to be the fool. The words compromise and moderation have taken on larger meanings. But there is one way of the world that remains untouched by all the sound and fury. That would be murder. Today, our story examines the odd circumstances that surround the fate of a common man. Walt Carter, age 55, owner-operator of the only service station on a 50-mile strip of highway along the great southwestern Nevada desert. We call it A Shortage Story.
Hey, Walt, the truck's here.
Tell him to start pumping, Jimmy. I'll be right there.
Okay.
So I leave all of my worldly possessions to my daughter, Patricia Carter Siri, except for the station and the motel, which go to my loyal friend, Jimmy Day, signed Walter Carter, March 13, 1974.
That's that.
Howdy, Walt. Hot enough for you, Scott? You want a soda or a beer or something?
No, thanks. Listen, I gotta be going.
Hey, you can't go before you leave me my gas.
I already have.
Impossible. You just got here.
Oh, Jimmy's locking up the storage tank now. Look, I'm sorry, Walt. 50 gallons is all I can leave you.
50 gallons? That wouldn't last me but a few days, even with so few cars coming through here.
I know, but I got my orders.
Look, if this keeps up, I'll lose the station. The motel's dying as it is. I gotta have more gas.
If there was anything I could do for you, I'd do it, but I can't. Now, come on, please, just sign the receipt.
Better than nothing, I guess.
Things will get better, Walt. Pretty soon people will be driving everywhere again, and tourists will be staying overnight. You see, it'll all work itself out.
I hope you're right. You sure you won't have that beer?
No, can't today. I'll be back in 2 weeks.
Two weeks? Hey, Scott! Scott!
I'll see you, Walt. Bye, Jimmy.
Hey, Walt, you know we're running low on soda.
Walt? Jimmy, I want you to go to town and mail a letter for me.
Honey, we can't stop at my daddy's place. It wouldn't be right.
You're his baby girl, aren't you?
But I haven't even written to him in 5 years.
We've been married that long? Seems like 10.
Just shut up, Dick. Look, it was your bright idea that got us out here in the first place. You had to gamble
with... Don't bite it off!
Don't talk to me like that.
You want more?
I'm sorry, honey. I love you. I'll do anything for you. Anything.
Just be sure the old man doesn't talk you out of it.
Hey, where is everyone? Oh, wow. Just look at the place. It's really gone to pot since I left.
Go on, get out. They better see you first. We don't want them to have a heart attack.
Here I wait. Patty! Is that you?
Patty. Oh, Daddy, I missed you so much.
Oh, baby, let me look at you. Hey, what happened to your lip? It's swollen.
I bumped it on a desk in our hotel room in Vegas. I was drunk, you know.
Our hotel room?
Dick's and mine.
Oh, I was hoping you'd left that bum by now.
Don't start in on me right away.
Oh, now, Patty.
We need some gas and a place to stay overnight, okay?
Well, you can have any room you like. They're all vacant, but gas or something else.
Hey, Pop, what's holding you up? This is a film station, isn't it? Fill her up.
Well, he's still a charmer, isn't he?
Oh, lay off him, will you? He's my husband.
Yeah, I know.
Now, be nice to him. At least try. Dick's mellowed.
Well, seeing your family, I guess I can fill your tank. Now, I can't do it for just anyone. We ain't got but 50 gallons.
Thank you, Daddy. I knew you'd be glad to see me.
Oh, that was mighty fine beefsteak, Walt. Mighty fine.
Yeah, you didn't have to go to all that trouble, Daddy.
No trouble. We've been keeping those steaks in the freezer for an occasion. And I'd call this family reunion one.
Well, I'm just happy that you're happy.
Now, let me help you with those, dear.
Well, thank you, sweetheart.
You didn't talk to him yet.
I will. Give me a chance.
Do it now. I asked Jimmy to give me a hand in here. I never washed a dish in my life.
Who is it?
It's me. Who do you think?
Now, where the hell have you been?
How'd it go?
I asked you, where have you been?
I drove to town to get us a bottle to celebrate with. There's your answer. Now tell me, how did it go?
Well, not so good. He doesn't have much cash on hand, and I know he wouldn't give it to us anyway.
What about the other thing?
Insurance?
Yes, the insurance.
Well, he's got one more premium to pay. It's due next week.
That's not too bad. We can stick around if I can stomach his attitude that long.
No, we can't.
Why not?
He knows we're broke. We have to leave tomorrow.
Why, that dirty...
Shut up!
Hey, you slapped me. You know what that means.
No, Dick, please. They'll hear.
Patty, are you telling me the truth? Now, Dick didn't hit you, did he?
I told you I fell in the bathtub.
Yeah, I know what you told me.
First you kick us out, then you call me a liar.
Damn it!
What's the matter, honey? Won't it start?
Jimmy, see what you can do.
Okay, Walt.
I just can't wait for us to leave.
You can stay. He goes.
If Dick goes, I go with him.
That's right, Pop. She's my little girl now.
Dick Seary, if I were 20 years younger,
you
I would...
do nothing.
It's a starter, Walt.
Oh, hell. Looks like we both stay.
I can probably get a rebuild in town. I gotta go in anyway to pick up a case of soda.
Mail this letter while you're there, will you?
Have we got enough gas in the tanks for me to fill up the truck?
How much we pumped today?
About 25 gallons.
I don't know. We'll have to shut down till Scott comes again.
Well, I'll take half a tank and see what I can get in town.
Now, Jimmy, don't forget to mail that letter to the insurance.
All right.
Dickie, I'm scared. What if we're caught?
Who's going to catch us? Jimmy's staying in town, and the old man's been asleep for hours.
Won't there be an explosion?
Don't be stupid. That's what the old man's been crying about. The only gas around here is in this can. We'll just have a nice little fire. He gets the insurance money, and his loving daughter gets her share of the payoff. If the insurance people ask where we were, I got friends in Reno who'll say we were there. We did leave this place 2 days ago.
I love you, Dickie. Tell me you love me.
I love you. Now get ready. There. Start the car. Now let's stay and watch. I love a good fire.
Well, can't we go? It makes me sad. This used to be my home.
Hey, there's a car coming. It's pulling off the highway. Let's beat it. Keep the lights off. Step on it.
You think he saw it?
Just drive. We can maybe get...
Why didn't you let me go back? Why? Oh, God, he's dead.
Shut up. I'm trying to think.
Daddy's dead. Oh, God, we killed him. Oh, God.
There was nothing we could have done. The story in the paper says he was killed in the explosion.
You said there wasn't going to be any explosion. You lied.
Get off my back. It shouldn't have blown up.
Well, let's go back. Give ourselves up. We can explain.
Explain what? That we only started the fire to collect the insurance money? Get something through that stupid head of yours. The police are looking for us, and they ain't interested in finding a couple of firebugs. We're wanted for murder.
Right there, Dick.
Wayne? What are you doing with that shotgun?
Been reading the papers. You people are wanted by the law, and so am I. How do I know they didn't follow you here, and how do I know you didn't make a deal with them?
Wayne, I wouldn't do that. You know me.
Now get that car out of sight. Meet me inside the house.
And that's the way it really happened. I swear it.
Funny, that's not the way I heard it over the radio.
What did they say?
They had a taped interview with a witness, Jimmy something, Jimmy Day.
What did he say?
That you planned the whole thing? Said he overheard you talking about blowing up the gas station and the old man with it.
That's a lie. We never said that.
Well, too bad you were seen. They opened the old man's will today. Looks like you got aced out of some bucks.
How can that be? The old crock was broke.
We never said anything about killing Daddy, never.
Yeah, well, seems one of the big oil companies wanted to buy that land.
What?
Well, hell, he was sitting on top of a whole field of raw crude.
Daddy never said anything about that.
The will says that Jimmy gets the motel and the station, or what's left of them. Looks like he gets it all now.
The hell he does.
Well, you can't stop him.
Oh, no? You still running hot cars?
Hey, you're not thinking about going back there, are you?
I'm not thinking. I'm going.
You say we run, then we come back in a stolen car. We'll be caught for sure.
Shut up.
No, I can't take this anymore.
All right, get out.
You don't mean that.
I'm waiting. Go on, walk. See how far you get.
Oh, Dick, I'm sorry. I was only kidding.
Well, I'm not.
Well, no, Dick. No!
Uh-oh, we got company. Could be the cops. Over behind where the motel was. Hurry! Sorry, we're closed. There's a station in town that... You!
Hiya, Jimmy.
Well, how did you... Well, where... Well,
you ask a lot of questions for a guy with all the answers.
Hey, now, wait a minute.
Shut up. You're a mind reader. You must know this gun is loaded.
Oh, now, Dick, take it easy.
Why did you lie, Jimmy? You had a good thing going. The motel and the station would have been yours. But you had to get greedy.
No, wait.
I'm not going to shoot you, Jimmy. I just want you to stand between me and your partner. Just in case he's pointing a gun this way. That's it. Now, hold it right there. Now, I got a few questions, and you're going to give me some answers. You see? Because I got nothing to lose. You got all that oil company's money to think about.
Well, Walt didn't know about the bid from the oil company. He just got the rotten end of the deal.
But you knew. You were the mailboy. Always taking letters into town. I never saw you bring any back.
But I didn't kill him. I didn't have any reason to.
What were you doing out here that night, Jimmy? You didn't come to warn the old man like you told the police. You had no idea we were even around. All of that talk about hearing us planning to kill him was a lie, wasn't it? Wasn't it?
Yes.
And you better tell me now the real reason for you showing up. You got 5 seconds.
We were going to transfer the gas, that's all.
What gas?
In the storage tank. When I saw the fire, I tried to wake up Walt, but it was too late.
You knew it was going to blow, so you didn't get too close. I wondered why you didn't go up with it. You mean the old man knew there was gas here all the time?
No, nobody knew.
You knew?
Yes.
And who else? Stand up straight. I wouldn't want to get hit by a stray bullet. You can come out now, friend.
Scott, don't shoot!
We were storing the gas here and selling it on the black market. I didn't want Walt to die. He was my friend.
You just killed your partner, friend.
I'll kill you, too.
Hold on. Maybe we can make a deal.
No deal. No one suspects me. With you out of the way, no one ever will.
What happened here?
Well, there's your killer. I think I got him. He went nuts, I guess. He just started shooting. Shot Jimmy in the back. He's over there, too.
You wouldn't mind coming down to headquarters and filling out a few forms. Legal procedure, you know.
Oh, yeah, sure. I understand.
Oh, honey, I love you.
I don't see why we can't do it right here. Just a couple of questions. Your name?
Scott Garver.
Age?
44.
Occupation?
I drive a fuel rig.
Employer?
I work for the oil company.
I'm Rod Serling. Close your eyes, exercise your imagination, and join us again on our next presentation of The Zero Hour.
A Shorted Story is an original radio drama by Kim Weiskopf. Jackie Cooper was heard as Dick Seary. Featured in the cast were Ann Whitfield, Carl Swenson, Jerry Hausner, Alan Berkman, and Jacques Denbo. Zero Hour, created by J.M. Colas, directed by Don Hills, is produced in Hollywood for the Mutual Broadcasting System by Radio Productions Incorporated. Music is composed and conducted by Stanley D. Hoffman, Rochelle Sherman, associate producer. This has been a presentation of the Mutual Broadcasting System.